Your character, I mean, Lafayette, I think until maybe the tail end of last season, was probably the loneliest character in the series.
He wasn't lonely.
He was by himself.
A steady date. I mean, he had clients, you know, to keep him warm in the cold nights. But he was probably lonely because he didn't have that special somebody, which he does now.
I just felt like, you know, he was kind of by himself. He had his cousin, but, you know, like you said, he didn't have somebody, he didn't really have a family. He'd just go back to his house by himself, and people would come to him for, like, services and drugs.
That's true. It does. The way you say it, it sounds like a sad life. It sounds like a very sad life. I never actually thought of it that way. He did go home by himself, and service people, and they came and got left, but it's just him by himself. But now he has somebody who's a fixture in his house. And he's certainly not lonely this season.
Well, it seems like that the other characters who are mortals have paired up with somebody who has a power, and maybe this is what's finally happened with Lafayette.
Yes. Yes, we learned last season that Jesus is a brujo, which is a witch, a Wiccan, a witch, and he's my protection. So.
Well, I can't wait to see more. Love watching every minute Lafayette's on. So,
thank you. I wanna do real bad things.